Hello everyone, this is Sudipto from Technical Potpourri and welcome to another video on Postman. So today I'll be showing you how you can do chaining request in Postman Flow. So without any further delay, let's find it out. Before I begin, I'd like to let you know, if you have any feedback, please put it in the comment section and please subscribe to my channel to get notification of all my upcoming videos. So I'll be implementing two use cases today. In the first use case, I'll be calling an API. In that API, if I provide the country code, it will give me the currency code. Then I'll be using that currency code to convert that currency to USD and finally print the result in console. So that's my first use case. In the second use case, which is nothing but enhancing the first use case, it will be the same API call, which will give me the currency code if I provide the country code. That's going to be my from currency. The second API call will give me the to currency. And in the third API call, I'll be converting the from currency to currency. So it will be a currency conversion. And finally printing the result in console. So use case 2 is nothing but give me the currency code for country number 1, which is my from currency. Give me the currency code for my country number 2, which is basically my to currency. And finally, do the conversion like from currency to currency. And finally, print the result in console. So let's see that in a demo. So here I am in my Postman workspace. So I have one API call, which is basically this API call. And what this API call is doing, if I provide the country code, it is giving me all the details of the country, including the currency. This is a global variable and the initial value is IND, and let's execute that. So it's giving me all the details about India, including the currency, which you can see here, currencies, and I will be specifically interested on this code, which is basically INR. Now, when I use this INR to do a conversion, this is my another API call, which is going to be my second API call here. If I provide my from currency is basically this currency, which is INR, and my to currency is USD. If I use this call, then it's actually doing a conversion from INR to USD based on today's rate, and the amount is coming up. If I give 10 INR, it's going to convert that to this much of USD. Let's do that in a flow. I'll go here, start with a new flow. So the first thing that I'll do, I'll create a send request. In the send request, I am fetching the country. Here I'll be creating a string variable. The value is int. That's what I want to pass in this one. So I am calling this API, the initial value I'm putting INR. So let's print the log and let's clear the console and run. The beauty of this one is that you can build this flow step by step. So first I'm calling the first API, I'm going to print the log. And here is the body, which is having everything, including my currency. Okay, so now I want to do a second call, which is my currency conversion. Here I'm going to call this current conversion. I don't want that anymore. So from here, I'll be calling this one, but I need to pass the variable, which is a from variable. So I'm going to pass that, and here I'm going to put body. I have to find, okay, currency and then code. So that's what I'm to do, and let's print the log here. Clear the log and execute this flow again. And here is the response. So response is showing everything. So why don't we clear the response and see how it looks like. So for that, I have to select another block, which is a select block. And here from that one, I need to choose the result. and finally print the result in my console. So now clear the console and run again. And that's the INR converted into currency, 10 INR converted into USD. And this is the result. So that's the first use case. In the first use case, this is my first API call where I'm passing the country code and it's giving me the currency, which I am passing to my second call. And in the second call, this is the currency which I'm getting from the first call. And then it's doing a conversion from my from currency to two currency and finally printing the result. But as you can see in this use case, my from currency is dynamic, but what about my to currency? My to currency is always USD. So how can I make my from and to currency dynamic? The way to do that, that's my second use case. So for the second use case, let's go to the collection again. And here I have another version of this currency conversion, where both the from and to are variable, which I need to pass. If you see the previous one, my from was variable, but my to was constant. But this time I want to make both from and to are variable. So let's build the flow. We'll start again from the same. First, I am going to create a send request, which is my first call. And here I'm going to currency code, yes. And this time I want to, let's say I want to convert from INR to CAD, which is a Canada currency, right? So for that, let's do a string variable. And here I put int, which is India. I'll pass that to here. That's good. So that's my first call. Let's drag it here. So that's my first call. Let's do another call. And this time I want to fetch the currency of the country Canada. And pass that here. So that's my from currency, that's my to currency. Now I want to call the second API, which is send request, the currency advanced. But this time, as you can see, it's asking for to and from. So my from is INR. So I connect this one here, and in the path, I'll choose the value which I'm getting here. In the to, I'll pass this one, which is my to currency. Perfect. At the same time, I want to pass this one. When this is successful, I want to call this one and also this one. And finally, I want to create a select block, which is going to find the result and put that result in the console. Okay, so let's review. And to start from here, this is my first request, which is giving me the currency code of Canada. This is my second API call, which is giving me the currency code of India. So from currency to currency. Then I'm using the conversion API, which is my third API. In the from, I'm passing the value which I'm getting from this API. In the to, I'm passing the value which I'm getting from this API call. And then this API is doing the conversion, like from INR to Canadian dollar, and then printing the result. So let's clear the console and execute the flow. As you can see, I got the result back. So if you can see here, so it's converting 10 INR to CAD, which is a Canadian dollar, and the result is this. So this is a way how you can combine multiple API calls and use the result from one API call and use that as an input to the second API call. And this is called chaining the request. So I hope this video is helpful. Please hit the like icon and share, and also please subscribe to my channel to get update about all my upcoming videos. Thank you.